Hi guys! My name is Princess Ivy Salon from Bachelor in Physical Education B. So for this video, we were going to talk about the history of swimming. Yes, swimming. So before we go further, let's learn first what is swimming. So swimming is an individual or team racing sport that requires the use of entire body to move through water. So, let's go to the history. Our ancestors settled down next to the life-giving water. They fish, hunt, and it is likely that they also dared to enter the water. But the question here is, what technique did they use to swim? The answer to this question is given by the cavemen. They showed their swimming techniques in the paintings on the cave wall. It is likely that they overcame water obstacles, dog paddling, and doing propulsive arms movement similar to today's freestyle arm stroke, or clangs to lugs and animals' bladders. In some cave paintings from the Stone Age, we can discover some kind of swimming-like moves, but it is not easy to identify the style. On an ancient Egyptian clay tablet from 4000 to 9000 BC, it is easier to identify the swimming style. The arm stroke clearly shows the moving phase of the freestyle arm stroke. One arm is depicted in a recovery phase above the water, while the other arm carries out and pulling action under the water. Swimming was not widely practiced until the early 19th century, when the National Swimming Society of Great Britain began to hold competitions. Swimming has featured in a program of all editions of the games since 1896. The very first Olympic events were freestyle, or also known as crawl or breaststroke. Backstroke was added in 1904. In 1940s, breaststroker discovered that they could go faster by bringing both arms forward over their head. This practice was immediately forbidden in breaststroke, but gave birth to a butterfly, whose first official appearance was at 1956. Women's swimming became Olympics in 1912 when the Stockholm Games. Since then, it has been part of every edition of the Games. The men's and women's program are almost identical, as they contain the same number of events, with only one difference. The freestyle distance, 800 meters for women and 1,500 meters for men. So that's for this video. Hope you enjoy and also learn from it. Keep safe and God bless.